Show is a Stone Stanley production in association with...
And now, an all-new episode of The Daily Show with Jon Stewart.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining us. And welcome to The Greatest Millennium. I'm Jon Stewart, and over the next 60 minutes, we'll take a comprehensive look at the last 1,000 years. You know... it seems like only yesterday I stood on this very stage, gazed into this very camera, and guided you through a fond look back at the first millennium. Remember? The centurions, the dancing monks, the vomitoriums. Good times. We began the millennium fearing reason and bound by ignorance, huddled around a fire of barbarism. We end the millennium fearing nothing, bound by technology, huddled around a computer trying to download pictures of a woman filleting a dog. Good times. Let's take a walk through our greatest millennium. 1066. William the Conqueror defeats the Anglo-Saxons at the Battle of Hastings. The decisive battle is captured for posterity by a revolutionary new historical technique, the commemorative rug. Yes, many fingers were pricked that glorious day. 1215. The Magna Carta, a guarantee of civil rights seen by many as the first step down the road to democracy that culminated with the 1997 debut of MTV's Total Request Live. Okay, Middle Ages, a little Black Death, some Gothic cathedrals, blah, blah, blah. Doctors treat headaches by removing your skull. And finally, the Renaissance. European culture awakens from a 1,000-year slumber. Exploration begins. Man uses the gift of reason and realizes there might not be a giant dragon 20 miles off the coast of Spain. 1776, triumph of the New World. A country is born as Washington utters the immortal line, "We will surprise the Hessians in New Jersey. But for the last time, Lafayette, I don't know which exit." 1789. Tull played. And finally, the 20th century. The automobile. World War I. The Roaring 20s. The Depression. The New Deal. World War II. Television. McCarthyism. John F. Kennedy. John F. Kennedy. The sexual revolution. Herpes. Yes. It seems that each time we take a step as a people, we take an equal step back. Tonight, we take a fond look back on where we've been, reflect on just where we are now, and guess wildly at where we're going. Will the next millennium usher in an era of unprecedented peace and goodwill, an age of Aquarius? Or should we break out the totes and prepare for the thousand years flood? Tonight, my Daily Show colleagues and I will explore these questions and many more as we take a long, hard look at the greatest millennium. Helping us out along the way, they might be giants. Stay tuned. Gentlemen.
The Daily Show, Their Greatest Millennium, is brought to you by Intel and by Best Buy.
Power of the Pentium 3 processor. Don't just get onto the internet, get into it at Intel.com.
The holidays are filled with dreams of what good things may come overnight. And to help make those dreams come true, Best Buy has become an official sponsor of Toys for Tots. This season, share the excitement of the holidays. Reach out, give something of yourself, and help bring a little magic to life.
Until now, there has been a wall between you and the tools of serious trading. That wall is coming down. The information and technology professionals use to trade is now available to everyone. Daytech Online. The rules are changing.
BarnesandNoble.com delivers books and music right to you. But we're always looking for a way to bring people more.
You ordered this book yesterday?
Yeah.
I'm gonna cook every one of these recipes for you. Bam! Right now. Give me the book. You know how to bam? Bam! Come on, chop chop.
Ah, essence.
Bam!
Bam.
That's some bananas. Bam! Bam! And we're gonna add some onion.
Bam!
Bam! Bam! Bam! Woo! Bam! 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 Bam!
BarnesandNoble.com. We bring writers home.
Hello, do you remember me? I'm Andy Kaufman from Hollywood.
Comedy Central presents the Man on the Moon Marathon, featuring rare footage of Andy Kaufman. And interviews with Danny DeVito, Courtney Love, Milos Forman, and Jim Carrey.
When I saw Andy first, I just immediately started impersonating him.
The Man on the Moon Marathon starts Friday at 8, only on Comedy Central.
Our boys moved in.
Welcome back to the greatest millennium. I'm John Stewart. So much has happened over the past 1,000 years, but you might not have known that if not for the work of a heroic band of selfless gadabouts, the media. Vance DeGeneres has more.
The World Book Encyclopedia defines media as an ancient empire that flourished in 500 BC. That is irrelevant. Rather, the story of media is the story of man's triumphant ability to force constant news and information to you. You. Probably not you. And you. But where did it all begin? Our journey starts here, at the dawn of the millennium, with me, the town crier, Vance DeGeneres, walking the streets, announcing births, deaths, and new ways to keep wood nymphs from tampering with your yellow bile. There was literature, but it was all hand-copied by monks, making it especially difficult to find the big book of Jewish humor. Cute though the Middle Ages were, the media had its limitations. But as they say, invention comes from necessity, like a mother. In 1400, German metalsmith Johannes Gutenberg changed history by inventing movable type. A mere 400 years after the Chinese, but as is still true today, we ignore them. With the invention of movable type, the masses were finally provided with information and warmth. Excuse me. I need that. I need your bicycle, please. Yes, newspapers tell everyone what's important and what's importanter. By the mid-19th century, news was bigger, but it still wasn't fast enough, hard enough, or deep enough. That all changed in 1840 with the invention of the telegraph by a man named Morse Code. Like newspapers before them, however, dots and dashes still could not satisfy our basic human desire to hear the cries of a baby trapped in a well. For that, we'd need sound, invented in 1500, but useless until the advent of radio in 1901. Finally, bothersome literacy was no longer essential to being informed. Now you could hear about the Great War from home, follow the influenza epidemic from your living room, and enjoy the simple pleasures of Jack Benny being cheap as you ate wood during the Depression.
Well, this is one of the worst catastrophes in the world, all the humanity.
Oh yeah, that's the stuff. But people still wanted to see the grieving families and the funerals. Yes, radio had a simple dignity, but as always, technology refused to be dignity's bitch.
Well, I'm not a
52 hostages were taken.
Pretty boring stuff. Only in the 1980s did that young child known as media finally become a mature adult with refined coverage like this. But let's face it, television news can only be on 24 hours a day. We need more. www.more.now. With the internet, we can get instant access to breaking news, drama, and tragedy without the outdated restraints of integrity or oversight. Plus, you could purchase my autographed underwear on eBay. Media had come of age.
And it only gets better.
And better. And better. John.
Thank you very much, Vance. That's a lovely report. Media sounds like a very interesting field. And with more on the media's future, here's Daily Show senior media analyst Stephen Colbert. Stephen?
John, here at the end of the millennium, modern technology allows us to report news as it happens. Not too shabby. But unfortunately, we're still limited to what has happened. It's time to break the chains. Anyone could report the day's events. But here's my lead story. Commotion on the West Coast today, as California was destroyed in a cataclysmic earthquake measuring 24.9 on the Richter scale.
Stephen, that didn't happen.
Not yet, John. But as a journalist, I can no longer wait passively for things to actually happen just so I can cover the story.
But that's what journalists do, Stephen.
Maybe for the last 1,000 years, John. But I've had my fill of following the news. I say let the news follow me around for a while. I've been waiting since I was a kid for California to snap off like a graham cracker, and, well, now it has. And I broke that story. Woo!
Stephen, that's a tragic story, Stephen.
In a lighter but equally shocking side note to the complete destruction of California story, no one was hurt.
How is that possible?
Who knows? It's an amazing story, John. I don't think I'm tooting my own horn here when I call it the scoop of the millennium.
Stephen, I'm sorry to burst the bubble here, but you just made it up.
Or maybe you just didn't hear about it because it was overshadowed by the discovery of that dinosaur in Canada.
How does that overshadow the utter decimation of California?
Well, for one thing, they found the dinosaur alive. Terror tonight in Toronto as a prehistoric Carnivoraptosaurus satisfies a 65-million-year thirst for human blood. I have obtained this exclusive footage.
Steven. Steven. What you are proposing here is pure fiction.
Put down the buggy whip, Grandpa! Here, let me get you some fresh parchment and sharpen your quill! This is the future, old man!
You honestly think this will catch on?
I have news for you, John. It already has. Back to you.
Thank you, Stephen. When we return, Beth Littleford meets Ted Nugent, Lewis Black, Signs of the Apocalypse, and God. What if he were one of us? That and more when we come back.
If it's Comedy Central and it's Christmas, it's time for the SNL Marathon.
Well, whoop-de-freaking-do!
That means we're going to stuff your stocking with an entire day of SNL.
They got Naked Elf. They got Santa giving it to broads under the tree.
Christmas, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa. We've got something for everyone in this day-long SNL Marathon. It all starts Sunday morning at 7, only on Comedy Central.
He's not here yet.
Can't wait till the holidays?
Want to make cookies?
Start celebrating now with Rudolph, Tree, and Candy Cane cookies.
Is that him?
Not yet.
Just slice, bake, and be merry. Because it's the little moments that make the holidays.
Ho, ho, ho. Oh, Merry Christmas!
Just past the rectory and up some cold gray stairs is the best place on earth to buy electronics, videos, books, even your favorite country music. It's Sister Maria's room. Because Sister Maria has two very important things: access to Amazon.com, the best site for finding whatever you have a passion for, and Visa, the online currency. A great way to buy Hank Williams' 40 greatest hits, and of course, something to play it on. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Winter's on the way, and it's going to be a tough one. In wintertime, nothing is more important than where the rubber meets the road. Don't let winter weather sneak up on you. Roll into Town Fair Tire for BF Goodrich tires starting as low as $25. Save on BF Goodrich. As always, snow tire changeover, tire rotation, and flat repair are free.
Name brands at discount prices. Town Fair Tire.
So damn deep in the woods.
We have to get back to the car.
Tell me where you are, John! Help me!
A walk in the woods becomes a trip into terror on pay-per-view. For the first time on television, words cannot describe the horror.
I'm so scared.
The Blair Witch Project, plus the exclusive world premiere of the Blair Witch Project music video. Spine-tingling horror comes home on pay-per-view.
One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Welcome back to The Greatest Millennium. Still to come, Beth Littleford finds the wit, wisdom, and pure stopping power of Ted Nugent. And the apocalypse, could it be coming to a town near you? But if I may, lost among all this hoopla is the real question. Why is the millennium significant? Truthfully, it's a religious event. The year 2000 is the 2000th celebration of the birth of Christ. If he had not been born, we wouldn't know what year it was. Sure, for the Jews, it's 5760, and for the Muslims, it's 1420, and for the Chinese, it's, well, who knows, but I'm sure it ends with monkey. But you see, over this past 1,000 years, religions have battled mightily to get the others to go by their respective calendars. Christians struck first by opening up a can of whoop-ass known as the Crusades. Muslims fired back with a ditty called the Ottoman Empire. And the Jews? Well, let's just say it was a good millennium to keep a bag packed. Which brings us pretty much up to present day. In a modern age when inquisitions are somewhat frowned upon, how do religions get their message across? Steve Carell has more.
I like to chop the devil up, don't you?
Thank you, John. For years, religion had limited ways of getting its message across. Religion's time-honored techniques of prayer, guilt, and of course, torture and yelling could only be done on a case-by-case basis. This could take months, sometimes years, to weed out and boil non-believers. Television changed all that.
The Bible says the moment you die, that your soul goes out into eternity, banished from the presence of God forever.
Now people could receive God's good word without ever having to put on pants. But more important than the message was the money. Even Hasidic Jews got on the TV bandwagon, and that band was playing a lot of klezmer.
Welcome to the 15th annual Lachaim to Life Telethon, starring Haki Abasara, Mayim Bialik, Gary Coleman.
Yes, the Jews have suffered a lot. And now, evidently, it's our turn. But it was the Christians who refined TV fundraising, favoring a kinder, gentler approach.
There will be 50 people give $1,000, and do it right now, or I am finished. Try me.
It's like you're giving money to a friend. One religious leader, Pat Robertson, used TV to warn us of the consequences of decadent behavior when he blasted Disney World for its annual Gay Days.
I would warn Orlando that you're right in the way of some serious hurricanes.
Hurricanes will hit Florida. Bold prediction. Jerry Falwell, Robertson's tag team partner, warned of an even greater gay menace. How could anyone think Tinky Winky was gay?
Uh-oh.
I stand corrected. So you see, the miracle that is television has created the ideal venue for our favorite religious celebrities to spread the word, to beguile us.
I love you.
To make us think.
They were going to show people that weren't even saved. Terminator 2! Terminator 2! At a singles meeting in a church! I mean, come on!
But most of all, to warn us.
You know, Chuck, we're living in very exciting times and yet alarming times, too.
Right, Rexella, because we're headed for the tribulation hour. Now, while this is alarming, it is equally exciting because it means we're on a countdown to Christ's return.
Steve Carell, ladies and gentlemen. I had one brief comment, if I could. What was that they said about the tribulation?
Yeah, what?
Armageddon, they said it was coming at the end there.
Oh, well then, I should be getting home then.
Thank you, Steve Carell. Is the apocalypse upon us? Only one man can tell us for sure, and that man is Lewis Black.
Let's recap. Just for starters, earthquakes in Turkey and Mexico that defy description, tornadoes and hurricanes of outrageously devastating force, the utter senselessness of Pamela Lee's breast reduction. We're not headed toward an apocalypse, people. We're living in one and we didn't even notice. The Book of Revelations told us about locusts and frogs, but these days it's worse. We're drowning in a sea of jackasses who just won't leave us alone. We want them to go, but they refuse.
I did not
have sexual relations with that woman?
Shut up! They almost topple a government, but she gets a book deal and he's still president? They're fine, but I feel dirty and I didn't do anything. I still can't touch a cigar or wear a blue dress. What's more, we get mired in the same old arguments over and over and over again. Look at that whole Virgin Mary with elephant dung censorship thing that Rudy Giuliani stirred up. I wouldn't hang that painting in my house, but I gotta defend it because of a little something called the Constitution. It's so annoying, I wanna put a bullet in my head, but I'm for gun control. This whole millennium's been a mess. The Crusades, the plague, Pat Sajak's late night talk show. This is why we develop distractions. Cable channels out the wazoos, computers, the internet, CDs, cell phones, VCRs, faxes, beepers. My attention deficit disorder has attention deficit disorder. So, is everything going to end on December 31st? No friggin' way. Which is why I want everybody to stop this Y2K crap. What's gonna happen to my money? Where am I gonna get my water from? If you don't understand that this is the hell we'll be living in forever, you deserve to die broke and thirsty.
Thank you very much, Lewis Black. When we come back, one man's search for a prophet, and me, Ted Nugent, shows Beth Littleford it tastes better if you kill it yourself.
Hi, I'm David Alan Greer, and you're watching Comedy Central, the network that speaks to the black community.
This holiday season, give him the first triple blade razor. Mach 3 from Gillette.
At EBWorld.com, you know you'll get the latest PC and video games at great prices as soon as they're available. We'll let you know which ones are cool and which ones are lame. Be the first to master the toughest new games.
Hello? No, I can't come in today. I have a really bad cold.
Yes! Always consult EBWorld first for great prices and expert advice. EBWorld.com, we're inside your world. Find the monster on our homepage for a hot deal.
So strange. I just never thought of him in that context before. He's always been more like a brother. But now...
CK1, Calvin Klein.
It's Twisted Metal 4, and Sweet Tooth is large and in charge with all the high-octane attitude you've come to know and love.
989 Studios.
It's a South Park Christmas of scatological proportions when Kyle gets a visit from everyone's favorite feces. It's South Park with skid marks, next Wednesday at 10.
Comedy Central's Comedy RX presents Comics Come Home, hosted by Dennis Leary.
Am I the only person in America who hated the Blair Witch Project?
With special guests Janine Garofalo, Jim Brewer, Wanda Sykes, Dane Cook, and Jay Moore.
Women, why can't you just go to bed? You go in the bathroom for like 45 minutes, it sounds like the pit crew at the Indy 500.
All to benefit Gilda's Club. Comedy RX presents Comics Come Home, Sunday night at 10, only on Comedy Central.
10 and 2/5 seconds, breaking all existing world records.
Welcome back to The Daily Show's Greatest Millennium. Still to come, our historic Man of the Millennium Award. But first, do all celebrities live in a gilded dreamscape of parties and luxury, carefree like a little girl on a summer's day? Most. But some choose a more rugged path. Beth Littleford caught up with one such individualist. Beth?
Thank you, John. Indeed, some celebrities will be ringing in New Year's Eve with a gala performance. But one superstar is preparing for a New Year's Eve that includes widespread chaos and a total societal meltdown. I recently flew all the way to Michigan to spend some time with a rock legend who's ready for anything.
As the Motor City Madman, Ted Nugent burst onto our nation's consciousness in 1977 with the hit record, Cat Scratch Fever. And 25 years later, he's still milking it for all it's worth. But as the millennium approaches, Ted has put aside musical superstardom to attend to more pressing concerns, such as stockpiling weapons and eagerly awaiting Armageddon.
You've talked about bow hunting. You've described the throbbing of the bow as the arrow is pulled back, the tension you feel as you're about to release, the thud you hear when you hit the target. For Ted Nugent, bow hunting sounds a little bit like what some might call a masturbation.
I think you're reaching here.
I don't think so.
Yes.
Tell me how they differ.
Well, first of all, you don't use your dick when you're bow hunting.
Maybe, but come Y2K, Ted won't be caught with his pants down. Unless, of course, it's the key to his survival.
Yeah! I do have some filters that would actually make piss potable.
Have you ever drank your own urine?
I've gargled with it, but I won't actually swallow. I'd be willing to eat my own digits, if necessary.
If you did have to eat one of your digits, how would you prepare it?
Medium rare.
You like things bloody.
But even if Ted eats every last finger, he'll never go hungry. And when the millennial chaos finally erupts, if Ted runs out of ammo, God forbid, he can make a lethal weapon out of even a ballpoint pen.
And when the turtle comes up, you just stab him in the head. It's like that.
Ted Nugent, life in a nutshell.
Ted Nugent's life in a nutshell. Eating and that's it.
Eating. You sure you're not leaving anything out?
That's it.
Ted Nugent, eater. For the next millennium.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Beth Littleford, ladies and gentlemen. When we return, what will the future be like and who will be its prophet? But before we go, a fond look back at some good friends who have left us over this past 1,000 years. They will be missed.
Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye, my friend. Why can't I see you again? Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye, my friend. Why can't I see you again? Why can't I see you again? Why can't I see you again? Why can't I see you again?
The Daily Show, The Greatest Millennium, is brought to you by America Online and by Timex.
This year, do your holiday shopping on America Online.
It makes holiday shopping simple, safe, and easy.
Shop without going to the mall. AOL is the best place to shop online with all your favorite sites, like AmericanGreetings.com, where you can make your feelings click with thousands of electronic greetings for the holidays, plus cards that you can create, personalize, and print at home at AOL keyword AG.
Shopping is so easy, I can actually enjoy the holidays.
America Online new version 5.0. So easy to use, no wonder it's number one. Sign up today.
Michael Landrum again for Timex. And let me just say, Timex has a treat for you today. The Timex Turn and Pull Alarm Watch. Just turn the ring either way and pull the crown to set it for short and long-term reminders. Let's try setting it for 11 minutes. Just turn the ring and pull the crown. Next week, we'll discuss waving. The Timex Turn and Pull Alarm Watch. So simple, we should have thought of it years ago.
Thought we only made cars.
Winter's on the way, and it's going to be a tough one. In wintertime, nothing is more important than where the rubber meets the road. Don't let winter weather sneak up on you. Roll into Town Fair Tire for BF Goodrich tires starting as low as $25. Save on BF Goodrich. As always, snow tire changeover, tire rotation, and flat repair are free.
Name brands at discount prices. Town Fair Tire.
So damn deep in the woods.
We have to get back to the car.
Tell me where you are, John! Help me!
A walk in the woods becomes a trip into terror on pay-per-view. For the first time on television,
I'm gonna die out here.
Words cannot describe the horror.
I'm so scared.
The Blair Witch Project. Plus the exclusive world premiere of the Blair Witch Project music video. Spine-tingling horror comes home on pay-per-view.
What did Ms. Lewinsky say in her conversation?
Welcome back. Earlier, Steve Carell showed us the many faces of religion today. Now he shows us the one face of religion tomorrow.
Dr. Ernesto Montgomery, psychic, seer, certified dental technician, and keeper of the renowned Weeping Shirley MacLaine. But he's best known as one of the top five prophets of all time.
The top five prophets of all time, as I
all
see
time.
It. Yes, happens to be Mohammed, Gene Dixon, Christ, Rasputin, of course, myself.
Of course. It's pretty heady company.
Absolutely.
You stacked up pretty well.
Yes, I have to concur and agree wholeheartedly.
To stay in the top five year after year, Dr. Montgomery has adopted a strict dietary regimen.
I would lean toward the prospect of the eggs over well and as part of actual French fries together with a well-done steak.
And over a meal of eggs over well as part of actual French fries together with well-done steak, it was time to learn what the future had in store for all mankind. What do you foresee as the future?
We prefer to eat completely, and then the conversation ensued later.
His meal complete, it was finally time for Dr. Montgomery to reveal what the future had in store for all mankind. But first, a few errands. And one more meal. In a nutshell, what are your most important predictions for the next millennium?
The abominable snowman that a lot of people have seen in Scotland will walk and sit and say, well, here I am.
He will literally say that?
Absolutely, yes.
It seems kind of anticlimactic.
Tremendously so. Tremendously so.
Thank you very much, Steve Carell. Now, we've given you a glimpse of who we'll be following into the future. But where will we be going? Mo Rocca opens the door to the next millennium.
Ah, the future. Just what can we make of the millennium to come? Since the dawn of time, man has enlisted his imagination to explore the dreamscape of tomorrow.
In the future, our clothes will be much different.
Soon we won't need money to buy things.
We may have cars that jump over each other, however, and have long extended legs.
So we'll be able to design whatever we want from the spare molecules laying around the house.
Traditional visions of the future share common themes: jetpacks, house cleaning robots, teleportation devices, and space travel for all.
Of course, that's rather fanciful. But what actually will happen is this. Humans will spend most of their time running. From what? We don't know.
But it'll be gaining on you, and it'll sound like this. And this music will always be playing. And in the future, humans will feed from any of numerous hoses found on the forest floor. Mmm, gravy. Must be a potato hose around here somewhere. But when you hear your pursuers again, you better keep running. Remember, running is the light, running is the path, running is the way.
And as for social mores and customs, there's change aplenty on the horizon.
There'll be a new language that kind of sounds like this that everyone will speak.
But what about the moth people?
The moth people are going to try their best to help us to keep the earth from exploding.
I've never heard of them, and I think they mean the cloth people, actually. I think that's a little strange.
But of course, our treaty with the moth people will backfire, leading to several years' war that's eased only by our new allies, dragons from the center of the earth.
It's very important for us not to ally ourselves with the dragons from the center of the earth. We have to fight them.
Well, even if this was to happen, I don't feel like that the dragons would be a problem.
We have to fight them.
Thankfully, though, our one-world governtainment system will create home theaters that will allow people and dragons to wipe away their troubles. Just imagine being seated in your very own colonic blaster chair, weeping through the climactic scene, while the intake spike fires a heady mixture of adrenaline, heroin, and raisinettes into your body.
Report to Sector 7 for gender reprogramming.
Well, I, for one, look forward to the future. I hope you do, too. Goodbye. Or, as we'll say in Dragonlish.
Thank you, Mo Rocca. We'll be right back with the Man of the Millennium and a chilling look at extraterrestrial life.
Comedy Central presents the Man on the Moon Marathon, featuring rare footage of Andy Kaufman and interviews with Danny DeVito, Courtney Love, Milos Forman, and Jim Carrey. The Man on the Moon Marathon starts Friday at 8, only on Comedy Central.
Sacred tombs. Ancient curses. The undead. Will the next tomb Lara Croft enters be her own? Get the game and find out. Tomb Raider, the last revelation.
PlayStation. Happy time for Latka.
This Christmas, Jim Carrey is Andy Kaufman.
I've always got to be one step ahead of them.
And Andy Kaufman is...
insane!
Comic genius.
Crazy.
Brilliant.
The Man on the Moon, rated R, starts December 22nd.
Have you been the victim of bad gift-giving? Someone's given you underwear so tight you were able to sing soprano? This holiday season, demand Flues, online gift currency. They send it by email, you spend it on the web, and everyone is happy. Flues, just what you wished for. It's the holiday, someone gives you a gift, you see it, you panic, it's bad. You want to be kind, you really want to say, what were you thinking? Instead, say Flues me. Flues online gift currency, they send it by email, you spend it on the web. How cool is that?
Cool.
It's the holidays.
Pikachu, Bulbasaur, Kangaskhan,
Golem, Caputo,
Meowth, Jigglypuff.
Jigglypuff.
If that's how your kids talk, then come to Burger King. Now every Burger King Big Kids meal comes with a Pokemon toy and trading card or Master Trainer trading card sheet.
the millennium. Alien life forms. Many feel evidence of their visitations already exist. The Great Pyramids of Egypt, the totems of Easter Island, and in the heart of South Carolina, one man waits patiently for their return. Stephen Colbert met this man.
South Carolina. In recent years, it's been a hotbed of UFO activity. So Carolinian Jody Pendarvis has built a UFO welcome center in front of his trailer.
This is a UFO welcome center where aliens can come down and talk with me.
Are all UFOs welcome?
Yes, right now, any UFO is welcome, no matter what kind it is. But please, be from outer space. Don't be from another country or so.
At 42 feet wide and nearly 30 feet high, this UFO decoy slash hospitality suite boasts of every amenity and the latest in UFO Welcome Center technology.
So this is your communication system right here?
Right.
You use Morse code to contact the aliens?
I flash the lights in dashes and dots.
And what message do you send?
I mainly send UFO, hello, and my phone number.
Do you include the area code with your phone number?
Oh, yes, yes.
When the aliens arrive, they'll be sure to appreciate the Welcome Center's little touches.
So they would come through the skylight on a tractor beam and land on the love seat.
That's true. So they have a soft landing. This is where the aliens could stay. I have a stereo system on the floor over here.
So there's entertainment provided.
As a scientist, Jody is eager to learn the secrets of intergalactic travel. But every secret has its price.
What if the alien said, you can come aboard our ship and look around all you want, but we get to anally probe you?
I would have to tell them no.
What if they promised to be very gentle?
Still be kind of frightening.
If you don't want to be anally probed, aren't you running a big risk by having a UFO welcome center?
I'm taking a risk. But I think it's a risk that the whole world could probably say, Jody, you did a great job.
Now that Jody's built it, they will come. But will they bring peace or a probe?
Peace or a probe indeed. Joining me now to discuss aliens in the next millennium is our distinguished panel of experts. On the left is Earth's UFO ambassador, Jody Pendarvis.
Nice to be here, John.
Next, we have alien abductee and frequent sperm donor, Dr. Terry Johnson.
Hello, Mr. Stewart.
And finally, we'll hear from Fran Baskerville, the singing psychic.
Hi, John.
Thank you all for joining us. Mr. Ambassador, let me start with you. Have you met the aliens? And if so, can you tell us what they're like?
Well, John, being the ambassador to the space aliens, I can't really tell you whether I've seen them yet or not. However, they've been on a long trip. Just remember, it took light years to get here. The clothes was probably rotted out, and they're probably weary.
So you're saying they haven't arrived as of yet. Dr. Johnson, I see you shaking your head. What do you make of the ambassador's assessment?
John, with all due respect to Mr. Pendarvis, there's been a ton of contact between humans and aliens already. Many people on this planet, including myself, have been forced into an alien-human interbreeding program.
So I see we're already mating with them. And is that breeding in the traditional sense?
Not exactly, John. The aliens insist that we only do anal sex. They feel it's the best way to reproduce on a mass scale.
All right, then.
Let's now go to Ms. Baskerville. Your thoughts on Dr. Johnson's reproduction theory.
Well, Dr. Terry Johnson, I think you might have to join your patients. Oh, yeah. Because I don't see any astral sex or any ass sex or any kind of bottom thing going on.
John, can I say something here, please?
Yes, go ahead, Mr. Ambassador.
I have a hole in this theory. I think there's too much emphasis on anal parts. I really seriously doubt if the aliens came all this distance just to put things in our behinds.
Well, now, Dr. Johnson, the ambassador brings up a very good point. After such a long trip, wouldn't aliens have other concerns?
No, that's a bunch of nonsense. I personally impregnated hundreds of aliens that started out as unfertilized eggs in the walls of the rectum. It's simple as that.
Ms. Baskerville, perhaps you could shed some light on this.
Well, Dr. Terry Johnson, I think you're all hung up on that astral thing, on that ass butt.
John, this is just plain old crazy. Thing, I think here we are trying to have a serious conversation about UFOs and aliens, and we listen to ass children's songs. This is nuts.
Excuse me, I can't have people talking at the same time. Dr. Johnson, could you please take your seat? Thank you, sir. I believe Ms. Baskerville had the floor.
Dr. Johnson, there won't be any more astral-ass children. There won't be any more black children, yeah.
Thank you very much, Ms. Baskerville. Now, I'm terribly sorry. We're out of time. Final thoughts, Mr. Ambassador.
I do believe the aliens could come this year. However, I really don't think they're going to come and see our asses, okay?
Dr. Johnson.
You have to understand, I don't choose to have this anal sex. The aliens force me to.
Now, Ms. Baskerville, again, I apologize for the brevity of this conversation. You will have the final word.
Aliens will be a lot smarter than us. You can bet on it.
Okay. Panelists, I want to thank you all for enlightening us. We appreciate it. We'll be right back with The Daily Show's Man of the Millennium.
On the 19th of December, Comedy Central gave to me two Christmas Soapbox, one Dr. Katz, and a bunch more animation.
It's the Christmas Animation Celebration. 3 animated hours of Yuletide cheer. Sunday night starting at 11, only on Comedy Central.
This French restaurant is so continental.
Let's share some chocolate mousse.
I'd share anything with you.
Trojan Man.
Did someone say sharing?
Trojan Man, what are you doing here?
Looks like you're pretty close to dessert.
Well,
yeah.
I'm here with Trojan Shared Sensation Latex Condoms, designed with unique textures for her and a special shape for him to enhance both partners' pleasure and excitement.
Check, please.
Trojan, America's number one condom, the most trusted for a most sensual feel.
That man ain't no closer to being a Duke boy than Boss Hogg is close to turning down a pork chop. Play the Dukes of Hazzard game, racing for home.
Hey.
This is for those
ready to hit the road.
Hit the road.
This is for the long way
home. Long way home.
This
is for those who want to widen their horizons.
This is for the passing lane.
This is for right now.
Right now.
Hit the road for 2.9% APR financing, and you can get average finance savings of up to $1,618 on a 2000 Grand Prix GT.
This is for me.
For me.
Hit the road for Pontiac driving excitement.
This is for me.
I'm Deuce Bigelow, your gigolo for this evening.
This holiday season, make a date with Deuce.
I have Tourette's syndrome.
Shove it up your ass!
Barely notice it.
Oh.
Deuce Bigelow, male gigolo, rated R, now playing.
All sing the same, throw cares away. Christmas is here, ringing the tune. Ring-a-ling-dong, ring and the bell. Ding-a-ling-dong, bell is the song. Ring, jangle, ring, call caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, happy bow, raising the sound. Oh, the day's on the tent. Yea, ring, while people sing song of the cheer. Christmas is here.
Damn deep in the woods.
We have to get back to the car.
Tell me where you are, John! Help me!
A walk in the woods becomes a trip into terror on pay-per-view. For the first time on television, words cannot describe the horror.
I'm so scared.
The Blair Witch Project, plus the exclusive world premiere of the Blair Witch Project music video. Spine-tingling horror comes home on pay-per-view.
This country was built with hard work and good tools. Today, the Harbor Freight Catalog offers quality name brand tools at the lowest prices from the convenience of your home. Log on now for a free catalog. Power and hand tools, automotive and shop equipment, air tools and compressors, metalworking and woodworking, all from our free Harbor Freight Catalog. For your free catalog, log on to harborfreight.com. That's harborfreight.com.
We'll be right back.
back to the show. No Millennium Special would be complete, and believe me, I've done a ton of these, without an attempt to find one person to represent 1,000 years of human achievement. I give you The Daily Show's Man of the Millennium.
Leonardo da Vinci, Ludwig von Beethoven, Albert Einstein. Men who've had a profound impact on the human race, for a time. But what of selecting one individual to represent all humanity? The choice is clear. Charlton Heston. Because in the beginning, there was God. And when God wanted to show what the creation looked like, he trusted only one man, Charlton Heston. And when it came time for that same God to hand down his rules, he gave them to Charlton Heston. Throughout this millennium and millennia past, Charlton Heston has been there as Mark Antony, Andrew Jackson, a Mexican. No, really, touch of evil, it's good.
The telephone is in the bedroom, senor.
And twice as man's foremost emissary to other species.
Take your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape!
In fact, Charlton Heston has stood face to face with the apocalypse and laughed 3, 4, even 5 times if you count earthquake.
They sure don't make pictures like that anymore.
And long before anyone else suspected it, Charlton Heston discovered the awful truth about the food of the future.
Silent breed is people!
Not Charlton Heston, of course. Other people. To this day, when God sends down his most holy messages, he speaks through none other than Charlton Heston.
I'm proud of our guns, proud of how we use them, and proud of what they stand for.
Charlton Heston is the Alpha and the Omega Man.
You're full of crap.
Charlton Heston, warrior, poet.
Silent breed is people!
Artist, defender of humanity.
Damn you all to hell!
Charlton Heston, the man of the millennium. Just for the record, he did not play a homo in Ben-Hur.
If Charlton Heston is unable to complete his duties, the car, the trip, and the cash prize will go to the runner-up, Mahatma Gandhi. That's our show. And to wrap it and the millennium up, They Might Be Giants will record a song on the first device to ever capture the human voice, an original wax cylinder from the Edison Laboratories. Thank you very much, and we'll see you again in 1,000 years. Gentlemen.
I Can Hear You, played by They Might Be Giants, for The Daily Show's Greatest Millennium.
I can hear you, just barely hear you. I can just barely hear you. This is a warning. Step away from the car. This car is protected by Viper.
Guess where I am? Calling from the plane. I'll call you when I get there. You won't hear a buzz, but I'm buzzing you. What's your order? I can
Oh, hi. I'm Matthew Lillard. You're watching Comedy Central.
You're watching Comedy Central. I don't know what you're wearing, but stay tuned for more stuff.
I'm going down south, I'm gonna have myself time.
Friendly faces everywhere, humble folks without temptation.
Going down south, I'm gonna leave my woes behind. South, I'm gonna see if I can't unwind. So come on down south, I can meet some friends of mine.
This is Shop Class. My name is Mr. Adler. For the next week, rather than your normal schoolwork, you will be learning how to make things. Now, does anybody know why you are in Shop Class? Yes.
Because we had to choose between this and home ec, and we didn't want to be sissies.
Wrong! You are here because you are America's future. You may someday be doctors, or lawyers, or scientists. Most of you, however, will be pumping gas or cutting sheet metal. And that's why we have Shop Class. Now, let me make one thing crystal clear. I don't like kids that screw around. You screw around in Shop Class, you can lose a hand or an eye.
Mr. Adler?
Huh? I was just saying that I want to know who is the biggest troublemaker in your class.
Tweak is.
Ah, no, I'm not.
Yeah, you are, Tweak. You always get in trouble.
Ah!
Hello, excuse me, but Craig is the biggest troublemaker in our class.
That true, Craig? You a troublemaker?
No.
Well, you better not be, because in Shop Class... Hey, did you just flip me off?
No.
Yes, you did.
Told ya. Dude, Shop Class sucks. Maybe we should have taken home ec. Oh, wait, dude. Home ec is for girls.
Welcome to Home Ec. For the next week, you will be learning how to bake, sew, clean, and make things that are lacy and pretty.
Woohoo!
Yes, Wendy?
I requested to be in Shop Class, but they sent me here.
That's right, Wendy. You see, some of you girls will go on to have interesting jobs and careers. But all of you pretty ones won't have to worry about that, because you can marry a nice man. And that's why we have Home Ec.
Woohoo!
I wonder why Kenny didn't want to take Shop Class. I don't know, he's such a wuss.
Hey, don't screw around. You screw around too much.
You know, you guys are totally wrong about Tweak. Craig is way worse than he is. No, he's not, dude. Craig is a wuss. Dude, if Craig and Tweak got in a fight, Craig would kick Tweak's ass. You want a bet?
Yeah, a bet.
How much? $5. You're on. Hey, Tweak. Dude, Craig chooses you. He wants to fight.
He does?
Yeah, he's all pissed off at you. So will you fight him?
Why?
Dude, because you have to stand up for yourself. So will you fight him?
He doesn't look like he wants to fight me.
Craig, can I talk to you real quick?